British Rail began today with nothing, hoping for anything. And if few trains ran at first, fewer people knew about them. The first of the passengers from Oxford and Reading into Paddington abandoned bus queues to board hurriedly announced strike-breaking specials.
Marvellous, yes. Show you, there is some good people about, isn't there? Train people, see, they're not all bad.
Outside, a duo of pickets, ignored by passengers, unseen by strike-breaking drivers, guards and signalmen.
They're doing passengers a very small favour. The real big favour for passengers is yet to be done by this government or any other.
As the day developed, Paddington's intercity destination board remained blank, but Western Region managed an hourly service to Reading and Oxford. Elsewhere, occasional trains were seen more as a victory for British Rail than a service for passengers. In the east, people who abandoned some of the day's worst traffic jams faced a worthwhile wait for a handful of trains from Southend to Seven Kings.
Right, my appointment's not till 1 o'clock, but I've been trying since about 9:30, 9:45.
Do you think you're going to get there?
Well, I can only about try.
Some of the train crews are working today, though, despite the strike. What do you think of that?
I think that's brilliant. I think it's marvellous.
Good for them. I got to sign. I'm just thoroughly teased off with it all.
And with enough signalmen on duty, the service was eventually extended into Liverpool Street. British Rail didn't advertise any services because they'd no idea if each train would run. But by mid-afternoon, there was a half-hour service to Ilford, some trains to Bishop Stortford, but no definite timetable.